Hello everyone. So do you know that NABARD was established on the recommendations of the B. Sivaraman committee that to implement the National Bank for Agriculture and Rural Development Act, that is the NABARD Act. So welcome back to the day 15 for the ARD question series of NABARD. And so before starting with the video, let me just tell you, if you can visit the website www.anujindal.in, there you can download the spotlight, that is the monthly current affairs. Also, you can find the link for downloading these questions in the comment section below. So let's start with the first question. As I told you in the previous video, I'll be discussing the questions related to tillage. So the first question is, which of the following is not the objective of tillage? Now, first of all, what exactly is tillage? So basically, the mechanical manipulation of the soil with the tools. And in easy terms, if I have to say, then making the soil ready for the next cropping season. This is what tillage is all about. Now, there are different objectives of tillage, modern concepts of tillage, different types of tillage. So we'll be studying about those in MCQ form. And there were questions from tillage in the previous year paper. So it becomes very important to study this topic, tillage. So the first objective or the first statement given over here is to control the weeds effectively. Now this is correct, because when we are making the soil ready, we need to improve or we need to uproot the weeds. So it helps in controlling the weeds effectively. Next one is to aerate the soil. It becomes easy for the air to penetrate the soil. So to aerate the soil, this method tillage is required. Next is to improve the pH level. So pH level is basically the chemical property of the soil which is not effective or which is not affected directly by the tillage. But while improving the soil fertility, then we can improve the pH level of the soil. Another one is to mix up with the manure and the fertilizers uniformly. So mixing of manure and fertilizers, so this is also correct. Next is to increase the soil depth. So suppose till this time we are just using this area, so we can use the methods to go beneath this area, therefore to increase the soil depth. So it's the objective as well. So as per this question, just to improve the pH level is not the correct objective of tillage. So moving on to the next question, which of the following is the method of conservation tillage? So this conservation tillage is basically umbrella term. Or we could say that it's an umbrella and it covers four types of tillages. The first one being the mulching or mulch tillage. The next one being the ridge tillage. Another one zero tillage. And the last one no tillage. So this zero and no are quite similar. So mulching or mulch farming or stubble mulching, these are all same thing. So the residue of the previous crop is being left undisturbed on the soil, and thus it helps in, as in the previous video I discussed about the soil conservation, so it helps in soil conservation from the soil erosion as well. Also, when the crop residue is being left undisturbed on the soil, the nutrients could be used for the next cropping season. Then it is known as the stubble mulching tillage. Next one is the ridge tillage. So what happens, this is a system involving the scalping and the planting on the ridges, which is built during the cultivation of the previous year crop. So whatever the ridge has been built during the previous year crop, that is being tilled at the time of ridge tillage. Another one is zero tillage or no tillage. So basically direct drilling. This method is also known as direct drilling. So what happens, it is a way of growing crops or pasture from year to year without disturbing the soil through tillage. So there is no usage of, or there is no movement on the soil except for the growing of crop. These all are the methods of conservation tillage: mulch tillage, ridge tilling, zero and no. Moving on to the next question. So the tillage operations that are carried out in the standing crop after the sowing or planting and prior to the harvesting of the crop plants are called. So what is this method known as? So basically this method is known as intertillage. This statement might look confusing to you, but in very simple terms, this is also known as after cultivation tillage. Tillage is carried after sowing of the crops and before the harvesting. So sowing of crops and before harvesting. So the period which is between the harvesting and sowing of crops, if the tillage is done at that particular point of time, that is known as inter-tillage or after cultivation tillage. And various equipments are being used, the spade, harrow, hoe, these all are used during the inter-tillage operations. So what is this? Now let's discuss about other methods as well. So what is this on-season tillage? So on-season tillage is basically operations which are done for raising the crops in the same season. So whatever tillage is being done for the same season crops, they are known as the on-season tillage. The preparatory tillage, as the name suggests, it is the operation done to prepare the field for raising the crop. As the name suggests, the explanation is self-explanatory for raising the crops when the field is being prepared to raise the crops. Special purpose tillage we'll be discussing in the next question. Now moving to the next question, so dash tillage involves primary tillage to break open and turn the soil, followed by the secondary tillage to obtain seed bed for sowing or planting. If you go through these options, then you can see that conventional tillage or the basic tillage is the, or this is the basic definition of the tillage, where it involves the primary tillage, that means preparing the ground for the crops to grow, then break open and turn the soil, followed by the secondary tillage and to obtain the seed bed for sowing or planting. So this is the method of conventional tillage. Now we are using the modern tillage techniques rather than the conventional tillage techniques. The next one is, which of the following comes under the special purpose tillage? Now there are various categories of special purpose tillage, and as the name suggests, the special purpose tillage, the operations are intended to serve the special purposes, therefore they are known as special purpose tillage. So what are the different methods? Subsoiling, clean tillage, blind tillage, puddling and dry tillage as well. So these all are the methods of special purpose tillage. Now let's look at each one of these one by one. So subsoiling is the very basic, or to break the hard pan which is beneath the ploughing layer, that is known as the subsoiling, and it is done once in 4 to 5 years. It is not done on the basis of the cropping season, but just to break the hard pan or hard rocks, the subsoiling tillage is being used. The next is clean tillage. So as the name suggests, the in very simple terms, if it is need to be quoted, so no living plant is left undisturbed in this clean tillage. So what happens is the entire field is tilled in such a way that no living plant or not even a single thing gets undisturbed. So what is the purpose of clean tillage? Why it is being done? So basically to control the weeds or pests, we use this clean tillage method. So blind tillage, in very simple terms, this is done after sowing but before germination. Now what is the purpose of this blind tillage? What is the purpose? As the name suggests, special purpose. So these all tillage methods have a special purpose. So blind tillage is done basically to uproot the weeds. So during the harvesting season, the weeds get developed. Therefore, to uproot weeds, this blind tillage is done. Another method, wet puddling. So puddling is also known as wet tillage. What is this wet tillage? So the tillage operation which is done in land with the standing water is known as the wet tillage or puddling. So basically the primary purpose is for the rice cultivation. So tillage is done when the water gets collected in the farm or there is standing water in the farm, and rice require more of water, thus wet tillage is important. The dry tillage is not the opposite of wet tillage, but it is quite similar. It is done so that the soil becomes more porous, because it's being done in the air area where is just the sufficient moisture for growing crops, and to provide or to make more the soil more porous, then this dry tillage is being done. So these are the different methods which are being adopted under the special purpose tillages. I have discussed about the conventional tillage and the modern tillage as well. The different methods, the no-till, the zero tillage, the stubble mulching, the ridge tillage. So these all are the different methods of tillages which are being adopted by farmers. So as in the beginning, I have told you that the Sivaraman committee is responsible, or the NABARD has been established on the recommendation of the Sivaraman committee. You need to tell in the comment section below that when was NABARD established. So in which year NABARD was established, you need to mention that in the common section. So the next video would be updated soon. Thank you so much for watching the video. Do not forget to press the bell icon and share this video with the people who are preparing for NABARD examination. Also, do mention in the comment section your reviews about this 5-day question series, how these questions are helping you in their preparation. Thank you so much for watching the video.